Now that I'm on stage with these heels, I can relax. Thank you so much for queuing up that slut. We are nothing without audiovisual, by the way. Can I just give a shout out for that? I picked that song on purpose because I don't know about y'all, but that's my hype song. You know, like, before I'm about to do something big or scary, we all got a song. And you can bring it down for me. Thanks, guys. Mike, you're awesome. I don't want to bring it down, but I feel like we should. But, like, everybody's got a song. Like that song that just takes you to the place you need to go when you need to do what you need to do. That's my song. It just makes me feel so confident. But I haven't always been confident. I'm not always confident. Now, extra? Oh, yeah, I've always been extra. Like, this is proof of that extra. This is your girl in 1989. I was 12. Okay, where are my people? Who grew up in the 90s? Where are my people, JJ? What's up? Yeah, okay, great. We can be friends. You might catch a 90s vibe throughout this presentation. That is on purpose. But yeah, like, and I feel like we almost need a slow clap for those bangs. I was 12. And the lift. I might have missed my calling. I don't know. What's going on, Amanda? I think that's Amanda Armstrong. Yes. It's so fun to speak in a room full of friends. But yeah, like 1989, I was 12. Extra? Oh, yeah. I've always been extra. Confident? Nope. Haven't always been confident. I am not always confident. I mean, just last year, I found myself on the bathroom floor of a gorgeous hotel room in downtown LA in a really iconic ugly cry. And man, I was excited about this trip. Like, I had packed my bags, I got to the airport, I was ready to go, and I was nonstop to LA, baby. Plane takes off, safely lands, and I jumped off the plane at LAX. We know the song? So I jumped off the plane at LAX with the dream and my shades still proudly on my face. My ego was so big, I don't know how I fit through the plane door, but I was coming in hot. I was ready to hang with my peeps, fellow poets, performers, and artists who speak at a conference called The Lightning Machine, created by mentor and muse, the poet and goat himself named Sekou Andrew. Now, this weekend was just for me. I was rolling solo. A chance for me to roll deep with myself, for myself, by myself. A weekend for me to tap into my talents, my voice, the divine timing of my life to address this tug I've been having in my soul. So deep down in my bones that I wanted to use my spoken word. Edit. Let me be honest with you. That I wanted to perform with my spoken word and be the verb that I was born with to wake up these gifts that have been lying dormant, to officially stop waiting for an endorsement. It was time to pick me. I had to holler at that dream, if only, just to see. So my ego and me landed at 9:05 on a Friday morning into LA, and after an iconic opening performance at the beautiful Del Rey, I find myself back in my hotel room by 9 p.m. the same night on the bathroom floor in a really dramatic, ugly cry. I was like, what am I doing here? I am so out of my league. Who do I think I am? I am not unique. I should have done this years ago. I'm way too old. It's probably the end of the road, and I should just go back to my comfort zone. So I pick up the phone and I call my husband back at home, ugly cry to him, start to feel a little less alone. And then I pick up the phone and call my bestie, give her the same ugly cry, both of them reminding me how brave I am to try. Eventually, I find the strength to stop the ugly cry. The clouds slowly begin to part in my self-induced dark sky. I pick myself up off the bathroom floor. I put my hands upon the counter. I wipe a tear from my cheek. I look myself in the eye. I let out a big sigh, and I feel ready to begin my rally cry. I go, Holler, do you know who you are? You're a star. You're an icon. You're a legend. You were born for this. You just signed up for a conference in LA to attend that conference by yourself, for yourself to learn and grow and tighten up your flow. You just put yourself in the room. You are in the room. That is brave. That is bold. Imposter syndrome hasn't arrived. You have arrived, because if fear is here, honey, you are doing it right. So I'm going to need you to get it together. I'm going to need you to light a candle, catch a vibe, take a shower, get some good sleep tonight, because, baby, tomorrow we ride. You are going to get up, dress up, show up, and get yourself back in that room, because you, my dear, are about to bloom. Mic drop. Boom. And I did. Just that. I got myself up. I got myself back into that room, no longer consumed with fear, kicking myself into a different gear, knowing that I would not be right here if something bigger wasn't the engineer. That weekend in LA ended on a Sunday, so I jumped back on the plane at LAX with a dream and a neon notebook full of ideas. My ego now had nowhere to go, because I had found my way back home to myself. I put my fear up on the shelf. I had just stepped into something else, something even bigger, something better, confidence. And I found it at a conference called The Lightning Machine, created by mentor and muse, the poet and goat himself, named Sekou Andrews, who taught me that weekend, who reminds me every day that maybe, just maybe, it's time to stop chasing the lightning and start making it instead. Can I get a holler? Confidence. I found it at a conference. And I think we can all agree that we'd like more confidence, right? Like, we'd like to make more lightning in our lives. I think we all want to live more brightly. I think we'd all like to cultivate the kind of confidence, curate the kind of confidence, keep the kind of confidence it takes to walk into new rooms, make moves, sign up for conferences, go to those conferences by yourself, pick yourself up off the proverbial bathroom floor in life. You will find yourself on at some point. And look, this is a worthy cause, because confidence drives sales. Confidence helps you live more authentically. Confidence opens doors. Confidence is how you make moves in your life. Confidence is how you draw opportunities to yourself and create opportunities for yourself. Just imagine how it would feel to walk into a room with confidence and leave with results. That's the game. That's the game. And this is a worthy cause. It's something worth looking at, and I know you value personal development and self-improvement because you're here, but that takes guts, and it's really hard. Plus, the problem with confidence is we do not want to look like we have a big ego, okay? We do not want to look like we love ourselves. Like, we've all worked for the guy in the middle. Like, we've all had a Miranda. Maybe you are the Miranda. Because if you're not laughing, it could be you. I'm just saying. Like, we look like we're so worried about looking like we're bragging, or like we're in love with ourselves too much. And like, here's the thing. People are so worried. The big problem, we're so worried about what other people are gonna think. We're so worried about people gonna judge us. Oh my God, people are not gonna like me. Oh my God, people are gonna make fun of me. Here's the cold, hard truth about that, and I hate to break it to you, but I've just gotta say it. We worry so much about people not liking us, making fun of us, judging us. I'm sorry, but people already don't like you. I am so sorry. People are already judging you, and people are already making fun of you. Can I get a holler for that? So the question is, who are you living your life for? Who are you raising those kids for? Who are you in your marriage for? Who are you in this career for? You or everybody else? You are strangers on the internet that you've never met, but I get it. Confidence is hard, which is why we don't. Which is why we hide. Which is why we stand against the wall. It's why we sit in the back. It's why we make excuses and judge other people who are doing it. And it's why we wait. For someday, you know, someday when I have the time, someday when I, you know, retire, someday when the kids graduate, you know, someday when I have this boss or that boss. I mean, someday syndrome, excuses, waiting is only going to guarantee that you will miss opportunities every chance you get, and you will end up with regret. And look, I certainly know a thing or two about that. Not a lot of people know that the very first time I signed up for improv classes at Second City in Chicago, like, I never went. Quick pause here, because we're going to talk about improv a little bit today. Put your hands up if you've ever been to Second City. Who knows improv? Well, let's get a temperature check. Put them up loud and proud if you know improv. Okay, so we've got some soldiers in the room and some people who don't know. So, cliff notes. Improv theater, it's a form of live theater. It's performed on stage by an ensemble, a group of people. The catch, the twist, is that we have no script. The plot, the storyline, the characters, the dialogue, it's all made up on the fly as we go. We use our training to succeed on stage without a script. And Second City's a pretty famous improv theater. Mothership's kind of in Chicago. People travel from all over to study there. Some of its alumni are people you may know, people like Tina Fey and Amy Poehler, and Steve Carell, and Chris Farley, and one of my personal heroes, Gilda Radner. Anybody remember Gilda? Oh, icon. So yeah, it's like a big deal to study at improv theater. And if you were to define improv formally, formal definition of improv theater is two or more people collaborating in environments of uncertainty with the common goal of creating a solution. Is this an event professional, or is this improv? Hello, art industry. Hello, event profs. Like, every day you are collaborating with other people. You're trying to create solutions for your participants, your attendees, your stakeholders, your boss, yourself, your family back at home. The job doesn't just stop here, right? And every day we're working to create solutions. So yeah, we're always, like, life is improv. So I signed up for the basic classes, the classes anybody can go take. It was called Level A Improv. Might have been one of the only A's I've gotten in my life. But yeah, really, it was a Level A improv. No audition required. I signed up, I paid the fee, the full fee, the non-refundable fee, by the way, for the entire semester. I left my apartment in Lincoln Park. I walked all the way to the training facility in Old Town. I walked into that building, up the stairs, down the hallway. I proudly stood in front of that classroom door. No, and I did not go in that door. And I remember lying. There was literally a lady, I'm sure I looked lost. There was a Starbucks in the lobby, and so a woman, oh my God, are you okay? Are you lost? Can I help you find your classroom? I was like, oh no, my bad. I'm meeting someone at the Starbucks. Mind pointing me in the right direction? She's like, I lied. I ran out of there so fast. I was so scared. I had a lot of fears. My biggest fear, well, I was not funny enough, not smart enough, not cool enough, but my biggest fear is that I was too old at the age of 30. Hold up. Do we have any 30-year-olds in this room? Put your hands up. Don't worry, I'm not gonna hurt you. Put your hands up. Are you 30? Who are my 30-year-olds? Put them up loud and proud. Where are my 30-year-olds at? Yeah, you little whippersnappers. Hold on, did I just say whippersnapper? Like, there went the cool factor's gone. I am officially over 45, right? Yeah, 30. There ought to be 30 again. Well, no, I like my vibe, but you know what I'm saying? Like, 30, I thought I was an ancient fossil. 30 years old. The question is, wouldn't it be great if we could stop doing that? Quitting on ourselves, missing opportunities, allowing fear to make our decisions for us. This is why I have such beef with the F word, the word that I think is confusing all of us. Because the world is telling you to go be fearless, baby. Fearless messaging and merchandising and bumper stickers and jewelry and t-shirts. And if you have a fearless tattoo in this room, I'm so sorry, because I'm about to go off. Think about it. Fearless. I think we can all agree, if you were really fearless, you would do crazy stuff. Like, you would never pay your taxes. I wouldn't. I'm fearless. Plus, I'm from St. Louis. I don't care. Like, let's go. I'm not gonna pay my taxes. I'd eat lettuce with E. coli. I'd eat poisonous foods on purpose. Okay, that was weird, but you get my point. You would jump out of planes without a parachute because you're fearless. You know, there's a lot of trash advice out there, and one of the trashiest of all the trashy besides the F word is this one, and I know you guys know it. Just jump, and the net's gonna catch you. Just do it, just jump. Do you know why people jump out of planes? There is a parachute on their back. Confidence, right? You better have something on your back, because if we did not have that parachute, it would be pretty dangerous. So no, the goal isn't fearless. The goal is this: brave. The goal, the game, is figuring out how to fear our fear itself just a little bit less. And that's how we start making moves and building confidence. So let me take you back to Chi-Town, back to the Second City Improv Theater 2 years later. 2 years later, I ended up re-signing up. It took me 2 years. I ended up re-signing up for those improv classes. I paid the fee, the full fee, the non-refundable fee once again. I left my apartment in Lincoln Park. I walked all the way back to the training facility in Old Town. I walked into the building, up the stairs, down the hallway, once again stood in front of that classroom door. But this time, your girl walked in. Yes. And what I didn't realize at the time is that I was quite literally opening the door to the rest of my life, certainly to life as I now know it. I went on to study there for 7 years. I auditioned for the conservatory, the professional program. Guys, I got in. I stayed in. I'm an alum of the conservatory. I started a business and wrote a book and pro speak for a living. And guys, that's all really great. And here we are. And it's great, and I'm proud of it. It's cool. But that's not even the best part of the whole story. Remember what my big fear was? That I was too old at 30? Well, let me introduce you to my first ever improv ensemble. First person I met when I walked in the room, her name is Shelly. At the time, 53-year-old University of Chicago professor, taking improv to think on her feet in the classroom. And then my boy Frank in the back, 50-year-old sales guy, taking improv to become a more confident presenter. And there I was waiting for almost 2 years. That brave moment reminds me every single day that if I am afraid, I am doing it right. Because I'm actually gonna be kept out of actual danger, or I'm about to level up and grow and brighten up my life in new ways. It's this mindset and that moment of walking in that helps me get up off the bathroom floor that I find myself on at that time, because we cannot avoid pain. It's coming. None of us get out of this pain free. Maybe you're in it right now. The good news, that's the bad news. The good news is we can increase our tolerance for it. We can build that muscle. You have got to be able to self-lead. Take ownership. Take personal responsibility and accountability for the direction of your success, your career, your health, your mindset. Like, no one is coming. And to be frank, Prince or Princess Charming has probably chosen another house. Like, you are up to you, and I understand it is so scary. okay? This little boy in the middle, legit me before every keynote. Like, are we sure? The braid, the what? You haven't even seen the boombox. Am I really doing this? Right? Every keynote. Like, I get it. But here's the deal. You're going to have to give up your comfort if you really want to build confidence. You're going to have to give it up. You're going to have to let go of control. And I know in this industry, we got our hands on a lot of switches. That can be really hard. You're going to have to surrender. And look, this might not be for you. This might not be for you. But if you want to live brightly, if you want the joy and the swagger and the freedom and the longevity and the flexibility that comes with confidence, you're gonna have to holler. And you holler at it by going where you have none on purpose. So let's redefine what it means to holler, shall we? Let's be the verb. I define this as the courage to face your fear, take initiative, take ownership, and go where you have no confidence. Keywords on purpose in order to go build it for yourself. And that's where we're going today. I've built over the years and created this sort of holla way of life that helps me do that. I think confidence is like a house. Like, you're not born with it, you build it. And every time you go somewhere new, guess what you're doing? You're building a new house. Like, you just keep building new houses because you've never lived there before. That to me is so exciting. It also means you're not supposed to know what you're doing when you're building a new house. And you can freaking renovate anytime you want. And like, I'm here for that. I have done a lot. Some of y'all know me. Like, I have gone through a lot of phases in my professional speaking career. Good for me. Because I'm building new house, new house, new house, new house, right? So this hollow way of life has allowed me to make sure that I'm building new houses and increasing my tolerance for pain. And most importantly, it keeps me moving in the direction of my dreams instead of my fear moving me in the direction of what fear wants. And fear only wants one thing, to stop you. It's so basic. Fear only wants to stop you. So knowing that is power, it means we gotta keep moving. So a quick pause here. Two things, a little housekeeping. So there are some, like, they were supposed to be like chartreuse, but they're neon forms on all your tables. Those are mine with like the records. We're about to get into that. There should be enough for everybody, but if there's not, use like your paper. But we have put together a toolbox. I'm gonna give you all the slides from today's presentation. I'm gonna give you my improv for team building workbook. I'm gonna give you my holy flow playlist. Like, it is a party. I just cannot do that without your permission. So if you want it, just holler at me. We'll collect those at the break, share anything else you'd like to. Also, there's a little game at the bottom. So if you're on Instagram or any of the social media, please, you have my permission to take photos and get engaged and tag me on social. I'm gonna pick my favorite posts and send you like a signed copy of my book. I'll pick like three or four of you this afternoon. But the reason I bring that up is I want you to take photos and have fun and get engaged here. But if you just don't wanna be on your phone, if you miss a slide and I move too fast, I'm gonna send it all to you. So don't sweat it, just let me know that you want it. Cool? We'll collect them at the break. That's my housekeeping. Oh, wow. Thank you guys very much. It's been wonderful. Okay, so let's talk about flow. Flow. Would anybody like a little more flow in their life? This is probably one of my favorite things to talk about because it all starts with flow. And most importantly, it starts when we understand that we are flow itself. And when I learned this, body of research that I'm about to share with you, I was never the same. And I don't think you will be either. And I think you're here. I always think we're right where we need to be, doing exactly what we're supposed to be doing with who we're supposed to be. Like, there's no coincidence in life, you know what I mean? I'm one of those girls, right? So water, you're water. So let's never forget, number one, that you, science, you are a body, you are 70% water chemically. You're 70, and your brain is 80% water. Did you know that? This is 80% water. This body you live in is 70% water. So you are basically an ocean. A walking, talking, flowing, vibing body of water. And what is water meant to do? It is meant to flow. It is fluid. It is meant to be in motion. You throw anything in it or at it, it's going to ripple and it's going to move. So I want to, and it has a very serious vibration, bless you, at that. And I want to prove it with some science and introduce you to a study called Water Consciousness done by a Japanese doctor by the name of Dr. Emoto. He studied water his entire life. He was probably the most famous water researcher of our time. And he studied specifically the molecular structure of water and how water changes when it's exposed to human thoughts, sounds, words, and vibrations. So here's how this went down. His research team goes to a body of water, same body of water, on the same day. They collect a major sample. They bring that sample back into the laboratory, and then they divide it up into two groups, group A, group B. They start with group A. They go over to group A, and they put group A in a bunch of different petri dishes, okay? One section of group A was exposed to classical music, Bach, Beethoven, Rachmaninoff, like all this beautiful stuff, okay? Second group was exposed to a prayer. Prayer from around the country, all the world, worldwide prayer, right? It was prayed over. And then the third section of water was exposed to positive affirmations. I love you, you're beautiful, you're safe, you're thriving, you're amazing, you got all this stuff, whatever. And they take that water and they freeze it. They put it in the freezer, okay? Then they go over to group B, same body of water, same day. And they divide that group into three groups, and some of the water was exposed to like death metal. And I'm not talking Metallica, I'm talking about like death metal, you know what I mean? I don't even know what death metal is, but I have a feeling I can catch the vibe. Probably not good. Then some of the water was exposed to negative thoughts, words. So, I hate you, you're not safe, I'm gonna kill you, you're gonna die, you're worthless, all this horrible stuff. And then the third section of the water was ignored. Put it in the freezer. They catch a vibe, go have some cocktails. This is how I envision it going. And then they come back, and then they pull the water out. And what they found cannot be unseen. Top row, group A. Diamonds, snowflakes, crystal clear water. The bottom row, not so much. Looks like cancerous cells to me, makes you wonder. Looks like craters on the moon. It looks like the face of Mars. It's dark and muddy and murky. You are 70% water. Your brain is 80%. This is why what you say to yourself matters. This is life or death. This is why what you say to your team, your kids, your family, the people around you, this is why it matters. This is why what you read and listen to and hang out with and read and watch, like, this is why all of that environment matters. This is no longer like cute woo-woo positive affirmations. This is life and this is death. So, we cannot avoid pain. Life's gonna hurt us. We're gonna face death and diagnosis and disruption, and we're gonna get our legs swept. So, on the days that we are feeling low vibe, by the way, we're keeping it 90s, I'm making you guys a mixtape. The first track on our brand new mixtape has to be Bring Your Own Hype, BYOH. You have to take ownership for the quality of your water. And the good news about this is that at any time, you can clean it up. Now, it may take some time. You might be in it. But we can clean it up, and you can keep it clean by really being mindful of who you're hanging with, what you're watching, what you're reading, what you're listening to. It's why I disappear before every talk. There are things I am doing from the moment I check into my hotel room to the moment my feet hit the stage to make sure that my ice crystals are diamonds for y'all. I'm being paid to make diamonds up here. You know what I mean? So you get my point. So I want to share with you a couple of things I do I brought some of mine with me. So I figure, like, let's show you the real, okay? So I call these my holla hypes. I've been doing this for a year, my poor husband. I've got like everybody, like my stepsons. Anybody who will listen to me is running these holler hypes. So you get yourself a little, I like pink. So a little hot pink index card, a Sharpie. And I call my shot. Some of these are things that I'm, dreams I'm hollering at. So these are gonna be vulnerable. These are real, okay? These are dreams I'm hollering at. They are also me making sure that my water is staying clear, okay? And so I will run these in the morning, borrow this idea, steal it, please. I've been doing it for years. I run them in the morning, sometimes before bed, definitely before a keynote. Anytime I feel like I need that like hit, or I feel like my water's kind of getting not so clear, I will keep it simple and do something like this. Pause. What you need to know too, for years, what I'm about to read to you, they used to say things like, I wanna be a speaker. Here we are. They say, I want to write a book. I want to start a business. I want to deal with it. And whenever they happen, I write the date on the back and I put it in this little like bedazzled manifestation box I keep in my office. Because this stuff works, baby. Right? Because what you say to yourself matters, but what you say to yourself happens. You ready? Here's mine. I am in perfect health. I speak in arenas. I get standing ovations. No pressure. I work with Disney. I got a big proposal out with Disney. I am safe to be seen. I live in the hills. There's this neighborhood I got my eye on. I am a regular on Good Morning America. I am booked solid. I am right on time. I hang out with Oprah. Why not? I am in perfect health. I speak in arenas. I get standing ovations. I work with Disney. I am safe to be seen. I live in the hills. I'm a regular on GMA. I am booked solid. I am right on time. I hang out with Oprah. I am in perfect. You see what I'm saying? And I run these at least three times in the morning, maybe before bed, certainly before a talk, because this is me making sure that my body of water is diamonds. You know what I'm saying? That's the vibe. I even do it in my hotel room. So I travel with these post-it notes and I put them up all over my hotel and they say similar things, but they're like, you know, you're amazing, you're a star, you're born for this, standing ovations, all this like beautiful stuff. But the reason I'm telling you that part is because when I check out, I leave them up. Because I love the idea of like the person coming in to tidy my room who has no idea who I am and I don't know what kind of day he or she is having, but they walk in my room, they're like, damn, you don't know what their life's carrying, right? And remember, some of that water was ignored. Some people don't have it. Some people don't have it at home. They don't know how to get out of it. They can't find it for themselves. So could I give it to someone today? So I love the idea of the housekeeper being like, and then all of a sudden she looks on my mirrors and she's like, I am a star. I was born for this. You know what? I am a whole vibe. I do deserve standing ovations. You know what I mean? Like she walks in my room one way and then she leaves like a totally different, or he leaves a totally different energy. You know what I mean? Some of that water was ignored. Some of us don't have that hype in our lives. So we have an opportunity as friends, as moms, as parents, as leaders. You got a team. You know, what does the body of water look like in yourself, but what does it look like on your team and in your world? And this in itself is a remix because it's you doing something different. Let's talk about the power of a remix. The whole point of a remix is that if you want something different in this life, you got to do something different. Like you can't do things the same way you've always done them because that's the way you've always done them and think things are gonna be different. Like we have to drop a new beat. We have to shake up the proverbial snow globe. So I ask you, when was the last time you dropped a new beat? When was the last time you've had a remix in your life? Are you feeling out of alignment? Are your sales not popping off? Are you bored? Are you in a rut? Are you stuck in stale, stagnant, boring conversations? I can guarantee nothing's wrong with you. You've just been standing in the same place for way too long. So our next track on our mixtape has to be one of my favorite songs, Get Comfortable Being Uncomfortable. The remix is uncomfortable, and you get more comfortable in uncomfortable spaces by facing it and going where you have no confidence in order to build it. And I tell you, the place I got the best education in navigating discomfort is no doubt the improv theater. So you could not bring an improviser here, give me a little stage and some microphones. I gotta do at least one improv game. Would anybody like to see some improv? Yeah. Every time I ask that, people are kind of like, ooh, ooh, what does that even mean? Okay, so here's how this is gonna go down. I cannot do improv alone. I brought a signed book. So whoever comes up to play with me will get a prize. But I need one person, one brave person. Okay, round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, our first volunteer. I love it. And we've got a hot mic for you. We get your dress tied. We, you know, we want to make sure. Yeah, we got your clothes are on. We're good. Yeah, hi. Welcome to
Chicago.
You're Chi-Town in the house. Welcome to my office.
Yeah.
Nice to meet you. I'm going to switch you sides. I'm going to give you this. We're going to stand a little closer to this line. And to test the audio for our AV guys over there, what up, Patrick? Just go ahead and say who you are, what you do, and where you're from.
Yes. Hi, I'm Danielle Schulman, and I'm from Chicago.
Represent Chi-Town.
Hello, Chi-Town. And I am representing myself today. I've worked in the industry, like many of you, for a very long time, but right now I am flying solo representing me.
I love that she goes, and I am representing myself today. Aren't we always? Aren't we always? We're going to talk about that. Okay, this is going to be fun. So here's what's going to happen. Do you plan events, or are you on the supplier? Like,
planning.
Great. So we work together. Yep. In your company, okay, we are colleagues, and we both plan events, worldwide, global events. We're global, okay? We work together. And this is a game, when you see the toolbox, this is a game called ABC. Steal these with your team. Guys, it's a toolbox full of, like, sales meeting and content ideas for you on how to play these games and debrief them. Plus, they're really fun party games, so have fun. But this is a game called the ABC game, okay? And all we're going to do is have a conversation. Okay, we're gonna get inspiration for that conversation in just a minute from y'all, okay? The catch, the twist, I'm gonna have you come up just a little bit more so our sides of the room can see us. The catch and the twist is we have to have that conversation one sentence at a time, and each sentence has to start with the corresponding letter of the alphabet. Oh, I know, it's it's terrifying. And I know what you're thinking, what's the alphabet? Like, same. So let's talk about this for a minute. Couple of things. Number one, here's how it may go. So say we get a suggestion of, like, vacations. I'll do a quick one-woman show. I would start with A. I would say, all right, I am so excited to go to Cancun. You'd say B, boy, I love Cancun. I'd say C, Cancun's my favorite. You'd say D, damn right.
Damn right.
Okay, you get the point? Yeah. Like A, B, C, D, and we go all the way to okay. Z. Cool, that's it. And y'all right up in here, my friends that I can see in here, we will lose our place. Sometimes we do, sometimes we don't. So just holler at us and let us know what letter we're on. But don't tell us what to say. Let us think through it. So they've got that.
Awesome.
Okay, so don't be scared of that. I'll start us off. We'll go back and forth all the way through. And when we're done, y'all will ravenously applaud us, okay, because this is scary. And then you stay here. You stay here. We're going to talk about it for a second. And then you can take your book and you're off.
Awesome.
Cool?
Thank you.
Any questions on the game ABC?
Nope.
Cool.
Sounds good.
All right, I got your back.
Great.
Cool. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I am so excited to have you sneak peek into our water cooler conversation today. We just need some inspiration from you to do that. So what is something that two work colleagues normally talk about besides other people? Keep it positive. What is something that two people talk about at work? Food, let's go, I heard food. Who said food? So foods are just our loose inspiration, okay, food. Who said food? Put your hands up. Okay, cool. What's your first letter of your first name?
A.
Okay, what's your last name? First letter of your...
B.
Well, that just made us easier.
That has never happened to me. Because what I'm trying to do is make it uncomfortable. Because we're talking about getting good. Because it'd be easy to start with A. Right? That's comfortable. Okay, who's your friend sitting next to you? What's your name?
Okay, I think this was planned.
I'm coming. Okay, what's your name in the pink? Kayla, great. We're gonna start with K. A and B and C. In 7 years doing improv games on stage, I've never had that happen. That's pretty awesome. Okay, so we're just gonna start with K and then we'll end with K. See, look at what she's doing. She's like, KB, I don't know. So chill, you got this. They're gonna help us. I've got your back. I'll start with K and then we'll end with K. You are gonna crush this. Ready? Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, this is our water cooler conversation just about food, starting with K. Kangaroo meat is my new favorite meat. Have I told you that?
Literally? What are you talking about?
Man, I'm telling you, it is so juicy. It just like drips, you know, when you eat it. It's like perfect.
Okay.
N? I think you're N. M-N?
Oh, N.
N?
No, that doesn't sound good at all.
Oh my gosh, you have to try it, and I think I'm gonna put in for our incentive trip in Australia. That's how much I love it.
Probably a really bad idea.
Quick! You have to change your mind on that because you are my best friend in this office.
Really? Oh.
Seriously. Seriously, you just are so positive, and I really am I'm so glad you're here.
Today's the day I'm gonna come through for you.
Unbelievable. I've been waiting for this moment, and what I hope even more is that you go for the promotion.
Very well.
Well, that's a great start because I think you can get us to Australia, baby.
Exactly.
You're right, exactly. And I'm telling you, we have worked so hard this year, we deserve to go international.
What letter am I on?
Z? You got the hard one, Z.
Zoo?
All right, there are kangaroos in the zoo. And that could, you know, give us an early, you know, vibe check on Australia. So I'm down for going to the zoo.
Absolutely awesome.
The B?
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
Boomerangs and boys?
Clearly we need boomerangs and boys.
Did the dingo eat your baby?
Everybody's been talking about how the dingo ate my baby.
Fantastic.
Gosh, this is so embarrassing.
Hello.
I know. It is an energy. I think we're really creating something special in this office.
Just so you know, I agree.
Kangaroos for everybody.
Kangaroos!
Let's go! Nice job! Yo, that's a hard game for people who even do improv regularly, right? You cry. You ever done an improv or anything like that? Where's your microphone?
No, I have not.
She's never done that. Okay. What I love so much, what I love so much about this game is you watch people come up here on stage with you and they are like shaking. You can feel them shaking. They're really nervous and they've never done anything. You have no script, right? You've never done this before. And you just did something you've never done. You got like a baby standing ovation in the back. You had everybody rolling. And I love it because it proves to you that you can do hard things without a script and live to talk about it. But it proves to all of you that if she can, you can, right? What was your favorite part about playing this game? What helped you succeed because you really did such a great job?
Thank you. I have a little bit of background in TV, so
awesome.
I'm used to kind of being up there.
Yes, you have some confidence. You've built that house.
I got to share that, and I like that the audience helped because I couldn't remember my alphabet.
Our ensemble, the energy from the room.
But yeah. I also like, I'm usually quick on my feet with things, so I liked to be able to do that as a refresher to remind myself that I can do that. I can be quick on my feet. I can have fun doing it.
Yes, you can. And you can make mistakes and fail. And live to talk about it. That's one of my favorite things about this game. Like, improv teaches us there's no mistakes, only gifts. You're gonna win or you're gonna learn, but we don't fail. Grab that book on your way out, it's on the counter
awesome.
There.
Let's give
her a round of applause. Really good. Really good. That's a hard game to play. I'm so proud of you. Really, really good. Really good. So yeah, that game is designed to teach us, of course, a couple of fundamental things. There's no mistakes, only gifts. You're going to try things in life. They'll work. You're going to try things in life. They won't work. We've got to keep moving, right? This game is also designed, most importantly, to remind us that you've got to keep going when things get hard and when things get uncomfortable, especially when things get hard and when things get uncomfortable. So I ask you, like, when was the last time you've done something for the first time? Or are you doing things the same way you've always done them because that's the way you've always done them? Like, what rooms are you putting yourself in? What rooms are you not putting yourself in? What excuses are you making? Where are you sitting in the back? Where are you hiding, right? Nothing is wrong with you if you find yourself stuck and underwhelmed and bored and in a rut. It just means that you have been standing in the same place for too long. The bad news, it means you're gonna have to start applying some pressure. The good news is that pressure, when applied to the element, is actually how diamonds are made. I think pressure gets a bad rap. I think we want to avoid pressure. And I'm not talking about the pressure from external forces, the pressures we can't control, other people's opinions, schedules, demands, external forces, the economy. Things are going to go up and down in life, right? I'm not talking about external pressure that is only there to distract and derail you and make you doubt yourself. That's not the kind of pressure I want you hunting down. I'm talking about that internal pressure, that internal fire, that self-leadership that drives you to overcome anything. And I can guarantee all the people that you look up to and want to be like and admire and read and want to emulate, they are all applying pressure. They are all really cognizant of their body of water. They are very much managing who gets in, what gets in, what they're listening to, what they're reading, who they're watching, what they're watching. They are very mindful of their body of water. And I can guarantee you they are dropping remix after remix after remix. They are trying new things and putting themselves in new rooms and making moves and introducing themselves to people and self-leading. Because it's that internal drive, that intrinsic drive that really helps us get what we want. And, you know, 15 years ago, I had a completely different career. Some of you know this. But I was in the biz. I'm a proud event professional. I'm still an event prof. Just these days, I speak in ballrooms instead of sell them. And it's not very often that I get to give this presentation when the woman who gave me my first job in the business is here. Is Heather in the room? Hopefully she didn't leave in my keynote. Heather Allison Smith, Ritz-Carlton Marriott now, big, she's a big wig. But she gave me my first job in the business all because I made a remix. I went to a meetings industry, an MPI meeting, a slampy meeting in St. Louis. By myself, STL. All let's. Oh. We are gonna be friends. It's gonna be dangerous. I can't. Precious. So it was in St. Louis, and I went to an MPI meeting, and these were back in the days when I like literally brought paper resumes and business cards that had my GPA on them, which wasn't even that great, which is so weird. Heather clearly didn't care. But anyway, she was standing in the back of the room, and there was like all this tea, and she was just like this tall, beautiful blonde, and I was like, self-leadership, you do not get in this life what you are not brave enough to holler at. Imagine walking into a room with confidence and leaving with results. I walked into that room with confidence and left with a job interview. I walked up to her, and I was like, well, hi, I'm sure. She called me like the golden retriever. I was like, hi, my name's Judy. I just want to introduce myself, and like, that's how it all began for me. It changed. She was a part of it. She opened the door. Kate Batay and I were talking about this. Like, she opened the door, but I had to walk through it. And I had to do it, and I had to show up, and I had to commit. And I remember being like, am I gonna have to make sales calls, like cold call? Is that, you know, what's a hollow square? Like she would draw, I had no clue. Remember coming into my office and drawing me a hollow square? What a round, I had no idea. She opened the door, and I walked through it. And I keep walking through those doors. So 15 years ago, man, that was my career. I built a big career in this industry. I'm so proud of that. And I had found myself at a place where my water wasn't really forging ice crystals anymore. You know, it was getting a little muddy and murky. And I knew I needed a remix. So remix, I moved to Chicago. I said, let's go to Chicago. Let's get out of St. Louis, let's try something new, remix. And then I said, when I get to Chicago, I gotta meet people, so let me get on some association boards and volunteer, remix. And then I start taking improv at night. I've always wanted to do improv, so remix. So it's about 3 years I've been in Chicago. I've got all these remixes. I'm, getting really brave on the improv stage, navigating fear, embracing failure. And all of that was making me like boss up in the boardroom. I started like asking the first question and speaking up and asking for raises and putting myself in places, right? Because I was getting brave. And so the intersection of that was kind of like 3 years that was all happening. And I find myself off Michigan Avenue at the Intercontinental Hotel in a big ballroom for a PCMA meeting. 500 people were in this ballroom. And a speaker was hired to talk about finding your purpose. And it was awesome. You know, we were at these rounds of 10s, and we tell this story famously to this day. Some of the girls that were at my table were in my wedding. They became my best friends. But he was giving this great talk, and we were all really inspired. And at the very end of his talk, he looks out at the whole audience, and he's like, all right, who's ready? And we're all like, ready for what? And he's like, who's going to stand up and tell me what they believe their purpose is? And I kid you not, I shoot up out of my seat like a cannon. My friends, meanwhile, everybody at the table's like, oh my God, this is mortifying. Please sit down. What are you doing? Oh my God, you're so extra, right? So I shoot up out of my seat like a cannon. I stand up and I point at him and I go, you. And he's like, me? 500 people in the business. I was like, you. I want to be a professional speaker. I want to speak for a living. 15 years ago, in a ballroom full of strangers, I hollered at the biggest dream I'd said out loud to date. 15 years later, here we are. It's how I make my living, right? You'll never get in this business and in this life what you are not brave enough to holler at. And you bet your bottom dollar that the people in the room that heard me say that, my friends, were some of the first to hire me, promote me. People were sending me books and introducing me to speakers and making connections. They were the first. I was so, like, talk about divine timing. They were the first people to bet on me and hire me and pay me actual money to speak on stage and to build this muscle and to build this confidence, right? So 15 years later, right, here we are. And even today, I'm continuing to apply pressure. So the final track on our mixtape has got to be Holler. We have to self-lead. No one is coming. You have to take responsibility. Leaders are exhausted. We are trying to take care of ourselves. I cannot babysit my team. I need you to take ownership. I need you to stop blaming it on the economy and the election and all the things that are going wrong. Like, you know, stand up. Take ownership for the direction of your dreams, the direction of your goals, the direction of your career, the direction of your life. Never forget, holler is a verb. I want you to be it. I want you to be the verb. I want you to have the courage to face your fear, take initiative, and go where you have no confidence in order to build it. Caveat, we've got a mixtape. Fear has a whole album. These are some of the greatest hits on Fear's album, and I know you know them. You might be feeling a few of them right now, and you are not alone. Fear is not going to make it easy on you. It's going to show up every day to try and stop you. But now you've got some stuff in your back pocket. You know that you are never stuck. If you feel it, you just got to remix. You got to drop a new beat. You got to shake up your snow globe. You've got to go somewhere new, wear something new, try something new, talk to someone new. You've got to shake it up. You also now know that you're a body of water. If it's murky, when it's murky and muddy, you now have a toolbox that's going to allow you to fix that. And you also know that you're a body of water and it's deeply affected by what you watch and read and listen to and take in. And this is not cute. This is not like little I am, affirmation statements. This is life or death, right? And you also know that you're a diamond. Pressure, when applied to the element, etches it into a diamond, right? And I'd like to remind you that you're already doing hard stuff and living to talk about it. None of you came in here today with a script. None of us woke up with a script. You have a to-do list, plans, but you still have a heart beating in your chest, right? You've talked to people. You went off script and you're still here, right? All of us have built new houses. My gosh, we've all survived middle school. And then went from middle school to high school. And then high school to like college and college to working professional. Some of us have gotten married, new house. Some of us have had kids, new house. Every time you take a new job, move to a new city, have a new boss, new house, new house, new house. You are already building houses and living to talk about it on the regular. On the regular, you're already doing it. So I knew that when I was thinking about how to end this presentation, I had to bring it back to the beginning. Because truly, you got one shot, one opportunity to seize everything you've ever wanted. The question is, are you ready to capture it? Are you gonna let it slip? I have mic runners, staff, where's the mic runners at? We need our mic runners at this point. But I have got a boombox full of stickers. And I want to know who's ready to holler at their dreams. Who's ready to say out loud what it is that they want, who it is that they want to be, where it is that they want to go. And you're going to earn a sticker for that. JT, thank you. I need mic runners in the room. Who's going first? Oh, we need audio on those microphones. It should be on. It should be hot.
I want to find my next big role.
Yeah, she's going to find her next big role, baby. Yes. Who's going? Who's going? We need more mic runners. Oh, we got some in the back. Okay. Okay, I got JT up front. Go for it, JT.
I'll be part of the LA 28 Olympics.
What?
I want to start my own company.
Yes!
You.
My sister! Woo! Let's go, baby. I love it. Yes. Trailblazer, trailblazer, and then we'll come back.
I'll be running a company with $1 million revenue.
She's going to run a company with $1 million revenue goal.
Let's I'm going to host my own conference, Eating at a Meeting Summit.
And she will. And she will. Where'd you go? There you go, my love. What you got?
I'm gonna get paid to speak, finally.
She's gonna get paid to speak! Yes, you will. Yes, you will. And you deserve to.
I wanna rock WWE WrestleMania as the in-house DJ in April right here in Las Vegas.
That's a first. That's a first, ladies and gentlemen.
I want to start my own podcast empowering women to rule the world.
Empowering women, baby! Let's come to the middle. Oh, we got Kate.
Kate, I'm going to be Judi Holler's best text friend by the end.
Yes! Yes, we are, my friend. Yes, we are.
I am going to own a vineyard with an event space.
I'm coming. I'm coming. I am so coming to that event space. And yes, we will. Watch out, world. There you go, my love. What do we got? What do we got? The things you learn about people.
I'm opening a restaurant in the next 5 years.
Ooh! I'm going to get promoted to VP and also be Judy's best friend.
Oh, my God. I have another bestie over here. Where's my bestie? Who just said that? Okay, I'll come to you. Rebecca, BB,
what's
what you
up,
got?
Girl?
Are you going to call it?
I'm going to call it.
Are you going to call it right here, right now?
Damn, no, I'm going to call it.
Call it. Call it.
Think?
Call.
I'm going to be the next chief sales officer for the city of Las Vegas.
Yes, she did. That was a close call. Oh my God, the song's almost over. Do we
run
that?
Okay.
Debbie.
I'm going to reinforce what I said to you the last time, which is I'm going to run a $1 billion company. But on top of that, I'm going to be on the cover of Smart Magazine. Smart Lou.
take it.
I want to make enough money to retire, but I want to work like I never want to retire.
Ah, I love that. Why do they put the word tired in retirement? I don't get that. You guys, okay, I feel, JT, do you want to say anything? I mean, you got the mic. Should we give you the final?
I think I want to put Judy on the cover.
Oh, okay. Do we have her in a dream? I love it. Take it away.
I get very nervous about public speaking, and you've inspired me to speak on stage at an industry conference.
Yes. That's so good. That is where I started. That's how I started. I always say start where you're a star. She got one more? Okay, bestie, you're my bestie. I'll bring you a sticker. You guys, thank you for doing that. How did that feel? And I know you, if you didn't say anything, I know you have something. Write it down. Put the date on it from today so you can come back to it and remember this moment, because that's what it's all about. It's about having the courage to speak it into existence, to call it out. And what's so fun, the WWF, like the things that I always tell my leaders, the corporations that hire me, what's so cool about this moment in the room for the leaders, the people who run organizations like Ford and Bank of America and Disney and the like, they'll watch their teams really say who they are and what they want, which gives the leaders really beautiful intel into how to motivate and incentivize and inspire and talk to and vibe with their employees. So it's a big deal. And I thank you for playing along. But look, confidence. I hope you found it at this conference. I hope you find it at this conference. I hope you feel ready to wake up your gifts, the gifts that have been lying dormant, to officially stop waiting for an endorsement, to holler at your dreams. If only just to see, and in case you forgot, I'd like to remind you that you are a star. You are an icon. You are a legend. You were born for this. You just signed up for a conference, attended this conference for yourself to learn and grow and tighten up your flow. That is brave. That is bold. Imposter syndrome hasn't arrived. You have arrived. So never forget, you are a whole vibe. So buckle up, baby, because today you ride. You are going to walk out of this room and bloom. Mic drop. Boom. Thank you so much for the gift of your time. Thank you guys so much. Thank you guys so much. Thank you guys so much. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thanks. Thank you guys.
Thank you, Judy. Thank you for helping us holler at